Hi, let's talk about the vasculature of the face. The face is supplied by the facial artery, which is a branch of the external carotid artery. In this image, we can see the left common carotid artery bifurcating into the internal carotid artery and the external carotid artery. We can't see the precise point at which the facial artery comes off of the external carotid artery in this image, but just so we could orient here, this is the angle of the mandible, there's the ear, there's the nose, and the chin would be facing away in that direction. We can see the submandibular gland here, and emerging from deep and a little posterior to the submandibular gland, we can see this artery, this very tortuous artery. This is the facial artery. The facial artery enters onto the jaw just anterior to where the masseter attaches to the jaw. Sometimes you can feel just a slight little bump or indentation in that place. People will refer to that as the premasseteric notch, and that's an excellent place to palpate for the pulse of the facial artery. The facial artery then continues medially and ascends superiorly on the face. So in this particular illustration, we can see there's the masseter there. There's the parotid duct coming across. There's our chin, and right there is where the facial artery is emerging onto the jaw. As we can see, it's rather tortuous, and it is winding its way medially and superiorly. And one of its first branches is the inferior labial branch. That inferior labial branch serves the jaw as well as the lower lip. The facial artery continues. You can see it rather tortuous here. And it gives off another branch. And usually this branch is the more robust of the branches that one can see. This is the superior labial branch, which serves the upper lip. The facial artery continues on, and we lose it here. It looks like it's going deep in that infraorbital or canine space, but it's ascending alongside of the nose, and it will send another branch called the lateral nasal branch. Beyond the lateral nasal branch, the facial artery becomes the angular artery. Now, the facial vein is very inconstant. We can see it descending down here, just adjacent to the artery. It actually has typically every branch that we would associate with a facial artery. So, for instance, there is an angular vein. And that angular vein can oftentimes anastomose with the ophthalmic veins in the orbit. And the danger there is that valves are not necessarily typical in this portion of the face, especially in the ophthalmic. Classically, the ophthalmic veins are taught as valveless, but there is some research which suggests that they have valves. And what can happen is that an infection can track from the angular vein through the ophthalmic veins, and then those are a direct route back to the cavernous sinus. But I digress. We can continue on. There's actually a lateral nasal vein branch. We can continue on down. There may be superior and inferior labial vein branches as well. But the other branch that I'd like to point out that we don't have a commensurate artery to pair is this one here, which is the deep facial vein. The deep facial vein drains deeper into the infratemporal fossa. It actually drains into the pterygoid plexus of veins, and from there may be another anastomosis back to the cavernous sinus. But that blood largely in the facial vein is going to drain down to the edge of the mandible and then flow back toward the internal jugular vein. The last vessel that we'll see, or the last vasculature that we'll see in this lab, are the superficial temporal artery and vein. We can see the artery here emerging from the superior posterior portion of the parotid gland. So it's coming up here. The superficial temporal artery is serving the musculature and the tissue of the lateral head. And it's one of the two terminal branches of the external carotid artery. The maxillary artery, which serves the deep face, is that second terminal branch. The superficial temporal vein is draining this region of blood, and it is draining into the retromandibular vein. And typically nestled between these two vessels in this region is the auriculotemporal nerve. The auriculotemporal nerve is a branch of V3, the mandibular division of the trigeminal nerve, and so it has a sensory component for this region of the lateral head. So we talked about the vasculature serving the face, the facial artery, which is a branch of the external carotid, the facial vein, and the various branches and tributaries of those vessels. Thank you for your time.